Hey guys and gals, what's up? Commander here. Welcome to another episode of... That's not really what I should have said. Welcome to my NXT review. I'm thinking I'm bloody playing games, but I'm not. But this is my NXT review. This was quite a good show. And that's it. See you later. Bye. Just kidding. We're going to get into it. First off, there was like a recap from Cena versus Sami Zayn from last week. But then we got into Solomon Crow versus Baron Corbin. Now, when I heard about this match, like, I read a thing, like, earlier in the day saying which matches was happening on TNA, on NXT, and I was like, Solomon Crow versus Baron Corbin? That's weird. Now, this wasn't, like, a squash match. Corbin did win it, but it wasn't a squash match. It was actually quite a good back-and-forth match. But eventually, it ended with this sick end of days. Where Crow like did a little, like he was on the outside, then he sort of stepped in and sort of springboarded off the bottom rope. I've seen Xavier Woods do that a couple of times as well. But Baron Corbin caught him and hit the end of days. It was sick. It really was. And the crowd now have finally sort of turned on Baron Corbin. I mean, I've been saying it for months that he's been doing the same old thing. But they finally turned on him and. There was Baron's gonna bore you chant. That was pretty sweet. And some boring chants as well. And it's kind of clear he's the heel now. Rhino came out and sort of challenged him, and then they had a little brawl, and some randoms pulled him apart. But I've heard that he's been playing the heel role in the house shows, and he seems to be a lot better at that. So maybe it'll work better as the heel. Just do something different, you know, instead of the same old matches. This was definitely different, different kind of match. You know, it was good. Crow got some good offense on him, and there was a pretty sick clothesline as well, where Crow like did a backflip. It was really good. It was really good. Good match. Next there was like an interview thing with Finn Balor, saying he will become the number one contender. And then Breeze has a thing saying pretty much the same thing. Next we got Sasha Banks coming out and saying that she made Becky Lynch and she's going to show everyone why she's the boss of NXT. And it says they didn't say the name, but it says she was facing Casey McIntosh. But I read that it's her actual name, or her wrestling name, is Casey Cassidy. But the fans were chanting black shorts at her. So yeah, we've got blue pants, we've got black shorts now, so there's a whole variety of clothing names at NXT. But Sasha Banks won. It was pretty good. I love that double knees in the corner that she does. It's so sick. And then she got the Banks statement as well, which is really sick as well. You know, the backstabber into the like crossface thing. She really pulls them back when she does that. It's really good. Sasha Banks is my favorite, you know, women's wrestler in the WWE right now. She's just amazing. I love her. I just reading the thing about like the main roster and the. In the NXT roster, about like people were saying that Paige and Natalya are like in a league of their own, and then somebody was saying that like Sasha's like better. She's like can work a crowd and get a reaction and what have you. And some like the person's like sort of thing for Paige was that all she does is just does her five moves and. Screams, "This is my house," over and over again, which is true. That's all she does, you know. Might not be her fault, you know. That's all she's allowed to do because, you know, that's what Vince and his in touch ways is all about, you know. But what can you do, huh? What can you do until he's gone? Anyways, there's a thing with Charlotte and Bayley backstage in the challenge. Dana Brooke and Emma at NXT TakeOver. Then there's a Yuha Nation vignette, but they still haven't given him a name yet. They still haven't given him an NXT name. I say just stick with the Yuha Nation name. It's quite unique. It's different. But next we got Carmella versus Alexa Bliss. You know, it was all right. You know, nothing special. She had her in a leg full Nelson, which is looks pretty brutal. Blake and Murphy came out eventually, and there was a "You look stupid" chant at I think it's Murphy. I can't remember which one of the two it is. Which one is who? Let me see. It's Blake. Blake is the one. he's the one with the weird hair. It's like this stupid ponytail thing, and they were chanting "You look stupid" at him. And eventually, won. Alexa Bliss won after like interference from them two ferrets. Like Carmella was gonna go for the pin or something. It doesn't actually say. Oh, she hit the drop tool thing and was going for her weird neck submission thing. And then they got up and sort of distracted her. Then Alexa hit the sparkle splat. She hit this. It was a weak setup to this, actually. She just kicked her in the leg and then she sort of like fell over, like the back of the leg. Then she hit the sparkle splash, and the guy here says, which is a Bam Bam Bigelow style moonsault for the pin. But it was funny, afterwards they got in the ring and the fans started chanting "no means no." It was really funny, and Carmella was getting into it as well. It was just great. But Carmella's, you know, saying that next weekend's when Cass will beat them, and there'll be one word to describe them: SAWFT, soft. It's pretty good. Fans was actually behind Carmella for once. Next we got Hideo Itami saying he'd like to face Kevin Owens for the NXT title and that he's going to win next week. Then we have Dana Brooke and Emma accepting the challenge of Bayley and Charlotte. Dana's still a ferret. Now we have Finn Balor and Hideo Itami versus Tyler Breeze and Adam Rose. It was pretty decent, you know, nothing special. There's a good moment before the match actually started where Tyler, you know, had his selfie stick with the phone and that out, and then he tells Adam Rose to come in, and Adam Rose is looking, and Tyler Breeze just like, it was funny. Eventually it boils down to Balor like was tagged himself in, Itami got the hot tag, but then Balor tagged himself in and we're sort of arguing. Balor hits the dropkick and is going up to do the coup de grace thing, but then Itami tags him in. They start arguing, then Breeze rolls him up, Itami up for the win. And then Breeze kicks everybody. He did the opposite of what he did last week with Itami and Balor. I think he super kicked Itami, and then the beauty shot to a thingamabobber, Balor, and then Rose is in and they're celebrating, and then he kicked Rose! I was like, what the fuck? But I have a feeling that Rose is going to be in this match, because if you didn't know, Hideo Itami's injured, and he's supposed to be out for like 6 months apparently, so I think Rose should have been added into this anyway, but I think Rose could get added into this, and they should. They should really let him show his talents, because this guy is really good. He's a great wrestler, and so I really hope that happens. If not, I don't know what will happen, and I'll have a separate video of my NXT Takeover predictions. I'll record it on Saturday, but I won't upload it till like Tuesday, because there's like Payback and all that crap. So I don't want it like being up and sort of not getting like the same sort of views as it would if it was uploaded on its own, you know. You know what I mean. But then afterwards we get like a Sami Zayn thing with comments after his match from Cena, where he thinks that his shoulder maybe popped out and popped in. So who knows? He wasn't really sure. But then we get a Zayn and Owens like face to face thing. And Sami Zayn's just like asking him if he did it for his family, or if he's jealous, or if Sami Zayn got there before. And then he asked if it was because of Kevin's son wearing a Sami Zayn shirt to school, and the crowd was like, ooh, or if he's wearing a Sami Zayn wristband, and then like he got out the, Kevin Owens got out the ring after that and goes up the ramp and says like he knows like how Zayn was hurt and he's still hurt and he knows that the injury is and he's gonna like exploit it pretty much and he's gonna hurt him again, but this time Zayn isn't coming back. Boom. Wrecked. Pretty good episode of NXT, and it was like 59 minutes because like when I loaded up the network I was like, oh my god, 59 minutes. But it went in pretty quick, you know, it's NXT, it usually does. I'll have my takeover predictions, as I said, Tuesday, I'll upload it. And payback predictions will be on Saturday. But I don't really think I have anything else to talk about. There's nothing really sort of controversial or anything like that happening. And if I remember, I don't really remember anything about Raw, to be honest. It wasn't a great Raw. I fell asleep actually at one point while I was watching it. I was kind of tired, you know. I did only sleep for 3 hours on Sunday night, which was my own fault because I stayed up watching The Walking Dead until like 4 o'clock in the morning. You know, I was ready to sleep at like 1 o'clock or something, and then The Walking Dead was on. It was on Spike here in the UK, and it was also on Fox, and it like one of the episodes was like from season 2, and then the other channel was there in like season 3, and I was like jumping back and forward between the channels because I haven't actually seen any of them, so it's really interesting to me. I just love it. I love The Walking Dead. One day I'm gonna watch all of them, and there's these online webisode things that happened. They don't happen anymore, but they happened between like season 1, 2, and 3, just sort of like to build up to the next season. They don't do them anymore, but I'll watch all that as well. But one day I will watch them all because I just love it. It's just so good, so good. It's my favorite show, like right now. And I've sort of watched the Breaking Bad. I've just seen like bits of it. I haven't seen like a full episode yet, but I've seen bits of it, and it looks alright as well. But I'm not gonna get into it because I got too much stuff to watch as it is. And it's next week. Next week's not gonna be good because I'm supposed to be working this quarry thing or something, and they work ridiculous hours. Like started like 6:30 in the morning, and some bloody times they're not home till like 8 at night, and there's just no way I'm going to be able to keep up with WWE. There's just no way. I would have preferred if TakeOver was this week so I could get it out the way. So I don't know if my TakeOver thing will be up on Thursday. Like, it's doubtful. I really don't... I'm going to see if I can try and like get out of it or not have to do like that amount of overtime, but that's just going to wreck me. You know, I fell behind a few years ago, back when I used to work with my dad, and it was pretty—it's crazy hours when I worked with him, and I fell behind. I was a month behind in WWE, and that took a while to get caught back up with that. And there was also at one point, this is when I wasn't gaming, like I didn't do any gaming at this point, because all I was doing was catching up with TV. There was one point I was over 100 episodes behind of EastEnders. That's a show that airs here in the UK like 4 times a week or something, and I was over 100 episodes behind. No joke, I was. I just couldn't get the stuff watched, couldn't get caught up. But then I did, and then I started doing YouTube after that. But yeah, that's my little rambling over. So tell me what you thought of NXT. You can tell me what you think is going to happen at TakeOver if you want. But I'll have my predictions. I've said it like 74 times now. Let's just end it. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.